let's have some session here. Chale guys, one question for you, 5 minutes. One question. Current cost is given, use your calculator, use your pen, pencil. Current standard cost of equipment is given, 1,20,000 in 10-11. It was purchased in 2001. Useful life, 10 years. Find the value in 11-12 if life is 20 years. Pehle first is 10 years. Second question is, if life is 20 years, what will be value in 11-12? I am again repeating, we are finding this equipment of 120. It is in which year? 10-11. Purchased long back in 2001. For how much? We don't know. God knows it. Its life was 10 years, estimated life. Find the value in 11-12. These are the rates. These are the rates available. Value was 120. Yes, anyone with the first answer? Value will be?
1 rupees.
1 rupee?
Yes.
Okay. Nail, ticket done. What about the next? I'm looking for both the answers. Both the answers, I'm looking for it. Next. First one is perfectly right. When the life is 10 years, then logically in 10 years, it must have been depreciated fully. So in the books, you can only show it 1 rupee as a scrap value, let's say. Irrelevant. But what about next? 11-12. Sir, please, sir, yes.
711 by 939.
7 lakh?
711, 711.
Right, sir.
Divided by, that is 939. Into 120,000.
Into 120.
Yes.
This is for the year?
For the year 2013-14.
2000?
13-14.
Okay. But question was not 13-14, but okay. Sir, 389 divided by? 711.
Into 1,20,000.
Right, sir.
It will be 65,654 something. And if it is 20 years, then in 10 years it will be 50% depreciated.
Okay. This is the value in 2001. Am I right?
Yes.
Right. We are looking at the value of 2010-11. Depreciation 20 years. So 65654 divided by sir? Right. We need for almost 10 years. I am telling you, you are not, might be at present, this is not useful because you guys are using only with the bills. But guaranteed any time in the life, you will find any such situation when you don't have a bill. Relax, it does not mean that you do not show the asset. You show the asset. Use your estimate, use your inflation index and find the value. Sir, ke liye, chocolate. I hope this was fine for everyone. Sabko yaad hai ye? Next question. I have just added one point and this is a valid point. Because scrap, you generally take it. 6,000. 6,000 sir, kam nahi hai bahut. Check kariye sir. Okay, good. Ye part to same hi aayega sir. Can I have the breakup? Breakup.
Sir, 3,272.
271. Sir, can you give me the breakup, please?
Sir, 65,054.
Okay, sir.
Into 5%.
Into 5%.
That is the scrap value.
Brilliant.
Value zero.
Why, sir?
Life is 10 years.
Sir, sorry. When you charge a straight line depreciation, That's the formula. Original cost is 65654 3271 by 10. So in 10 years, you will charge only the depreciable amount. And depreciable amount is always a cost minus scrap. So guaranteed in 10 years, I agree, you will write off C minus S. But at least the logic is clear. Everyone, please understand why I'm just raising this. Because you should know if rate is not given for any asset. Please, please, never think that you can't find out the rate. I'll take 2-3 minutes all to find out the rates. I'm giving one more question. Let's see. If I'm telling you, there's one query. One computer is purchased, right? Yeah, let's suppose one equipment is there. And they are not, and that institute is not satisfied with the rates given. They are saying its scrap value will be 20 rupees and our cost price is 1000. And we hope to use this equipment for 15 years. And we know it will be used in this way. Double shift, triple shift in the first 2 years, 3 years, and then goes down. Goes down means now usage is more and slowly the use will be less. Right method is, the institute is asking you, there is one asset, one new equipment, uska scrap value 20 hai, 15 years use hoga wo. It will be used for 15 years and the cost is 1000. Give me the rate of depreciation. 6 point. Sir, can you please do it here? Right, sir. Right, sir.
Then divided by the life span.
Nay, sir. Nay. Nay, sir. This is straight line. No. If we apply 6.5%, na, guaranteed last mein 20 nahi aayega. Scrap nahi aa sakta 20. No. Because I am raising this point, a lot of times you see that rate is not given and we write in our notes accounts as rate is not given, no depreciation charge. Why, bhai? You know the, you can estimate the life, you know the cost, you can find out. I am waiting for the rate. Anyone can give me the rate. Double chocolate for that. Yes, sir. 20 years? No. No, sir. In WDV is what? Your value keep on decreasing, it will never be zero. So scrap has to be there, sir. Sir, I can find out and I'll do it. I'll do it. I'm raising this. I'll do it in 2 minutes. In WDV, what happens? If I'm assuming first, if this is 10% you applied here, then next year you apply 10% on this. I think in this way we do it. This means every year our base gets changed. And when base gets changed, it is known as compounding. There is a formula for this, sir. It is a compounding. And compounding, I hope this formula all of us knows. It is given in AS-6 illustrations. How to find out the rate? This everyone knows, sir? Amount is what? Future or present? Yes, future. Tell me here, which one is the future part? Which one is future? 20. Which one is current? In depreciation, value decreases. How many years? 15 years. You can solve this by Excel. You can solve this by Calci also, simple trick. There's a simple trick in calculator, just see. If I solve this, 2 by 100, this is 0.02, 1 by 15, let me do it. And this, we have been using it in those assets jiska rate kahi nahi likha hota. A lot of assets. Just see. 0.02. A simple trick. Excel mein toh directly aaya tha ye. Excel mein directly aa jayega log se. Or using the power approach. Agar mujhe yahan par aapko show karna hai. 0.02. A simple trick in Calci. Root 12 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 times. No, sir. This is a common trick. Bring any number. Common trick. Minus 1. Divide by that number jo power mein hai. Power mein number kya tha? 15 tha. Ma'am, I'll write it also. I'll write it. Power mein 15 number tha. Agar 14 hai, 14 se kar diye, you have divide. Plus 1. Last step. Into equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. You get the value as 0.77. You get your rate. So, rate you can calculate. I just want to put this. कि at least rates अगर नहीं है निकाल सकते हम लोग और ये कोई Calci तो हमें चाहिए नहीं because nowadays we know the Excel. It's very simple. If you want to note on the trick, most welcome. Root 12 times minus 1 divide by that number. I hope rate का logic clear है. Please, calculation se mujhe matlab nahi hai. Calculation, I know all of you are more expert than me. My purpose was ki at least you can find out the rate. Agar nahi rate given hai, sir, tension mat lijiye aap. Aap rate nikal lo. Ye method allowed hai. Normal approach hai. It's given in all the books. Tell me here. Another question for you. Another question. As per AS-6, and AS-6 allows both the methods. Remember, don't go by WDV. AS-6 allows both the methods. Do not waste time in WDV. You can do by any method. Bolo kitna sir? Haan, pehle aapne SLM kiya. That was, it was written there to go by WDV. Reason company was saying, we will use higher earlier and reduce in the later years. Isme, as per AS-6,
18%.
I want a rate, 20%, okay. One approach, one answer is 20% SLM. Okay, done. It says AS-6 says both, perfectly fine. One answer is 18%, okay.
SLM
18%. First, let's check which one is right. If I apply 10 lakh, first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. If I apply 18, 1 lakh 80, 1 lakh 80, 180, 180, and 180. 2 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh. In this, scrap is 0. Here scrap is 1. Which one is the right method? Number 1 nahi hoga madam. Because in because ma'am, in this question scrap value was given.
1 lakh.
Scrap value is given. Sir, why I am raising this again and again, you must be thinking, in New Companies Act, it is given that if scrap value is not given, assume 5%. Assume 5%. Now, scrap value, you can easily assume it, your base. The problem generally arises to us because we don't have a base to justify it. Now you have a base for scrap value. It is given 5%.
So what period is 5% of what
period? Sir, scrap value ka koi period nahi hota sir. Scrap value apne 5% assume ki life hai. Right? Any period you assume ki 5% is the minimum scrap value to assume it. Minimum. So logically, if you are thinking sir, ki after 2 years, you are disposing it off. Certainly, sir, scrap value will be more. But it, again, it all depends upon asset to asset. You are showing mobile phone as an asset. After 2 years, I am telling you, even you will not even get 10%, depending on the models. So that 5% is the minimum value which is given there. Now, there was yesterday one more query regarding the change of the method. These are the things which are given in your annual reports regarding AS-6. Different organizations. Book received as gift are valued at selling price. So some organizations have valued the books at a selling price. Then some have capitalized e-journals, which depends upon the, I'm not saying wrong or right. Some are following an e-journal, they are charging depreciation 40%. Library books, they are charging 10%. Why I'm just sharing? Because practices might be different. On addition, full depreciation irrespective of the time period. Irrespective of the time period. Chahe wo addition, aapne 15th March 2014 ko bhi kara hai. तो भी डेप्रिसिएशन फुल ईयर का चार्ज हो रहा है. फुल्ली डेप्रिशिएटेड एसेट, इट मीन्स एसेट विच इज रिटर्न ऑफ फ्रॉम द बुक्स, दे आर स्टिल शोइंग इट, विच इज अ गुड प्रैक्टिस बिकॉज फिजिकली इट इज विद यू. एसेट क्रिएटेड आउट ऑफ फंड्स वेयर ओनरशिप इज विद स्पॉन्सर्स बट यूज बाय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ये पॉइंट 2-3 इंस्टीट्यूशन ने पूछा था बट नो वन वॉज क्लियर, इवन आई एम नॉट क्लियर अबाउट दिस बिकॉज देयर अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्कशन ऑन दिस. सो लेट मी चेक दिस पॉइंट. Some organizations are not even showing it as a fixed asset, they are showing in the notes. But it's a good at least they are disclosing it. Some organizations are not charging depreciation on the assets. Now you tell me which one is not appropriate. First one, bilkul theek hai sir. Selling price ka logic nahi banta sir. Then, second sir, depend karta hai. Second is, it all depends upon the type of journal and the agreement which you have it. It all depends upon that. It all depends upon that. I am at least not satisfied with the on addition full depreciation. Because at least you should go by the either by income tax rule, 6 months, or by the time based. Otherwise, if you charge full depreciation, then it means 1st April full, 31st March full, which is wrong. Cannot be. These are the main which you were asking yesterday. Can we change the depreciation method anytime? No. If you guys are following, let's suppose at present everyone is following SLM and now you want to change it, you will have to justify why. Who is saying? Is it is given in any accounting standards? No. Let's suppose all of you were following Companies Act depreciation, but now Companies Act has been changed. You can immediately say yes, now I can change my method because compliance of the law has been changed. Earlier we were following Companies Act has been changed, new rates are there, new lives are there, you can change it. It is not a deviation, even auditor will allow this.
Can any item which has been calculated on the above mentioned values or the formula, and if that
item has to be disposed of. Can item be disposed of, write off, written off, or sale off less than the depreciated calculated value?
Why not, sir? Why not? Sir, market value and the book value are very different. Why not? Take example, computer. Computer income tax says 60%. If I purchase 50,000 computer rupees and 60% depreciation in 1 year, right? It means now the value is 20,000, but after 1 year, 50,000 computer in the market, at least you can sell it for 32,000 or 35,000 rupees. That will be a profit. And this we were discussing. That profit which you have got it from sale of the asset is your income. Is your income. So that is shown in your income expenditure account.
Suppose a computer, let's say computer is purchased 10 years before, some big machine. And that machines now we want to dispose because of have no values, no practical value. So, and the depreciation value when we will calculate, let's say comes 10,000 rupees. But in the market, no one even wish to take off even for 5,000 rupees. Then how to write off that?
Question is, sir. Loss is sale of assets. Simple. Book value is 10,000. If anyone is purchasing for 2,000, right? Then simple. I'll take one more example for this. What you're saying. In my balance sheet, when I purchase mobile, let's say BlackBerry earlier, I purchased for 25,000 rupees. When I purchased, it was purchased, let's say 1st February. So I charge as per income tax rate, 25%. So logically, the value still should be this. After 6 months when I sold it and I exchanged it for a new mobile, it was valued for only 5,000 rupees. Take the iPhones. Sir, I focus on 5S 9 model I have. After 6 months you take it, you are purchasing for 50,000 rupees. But after 6 months, I'm telling you the market, it will not be even, no one will purchase even for 30,000 because a new model will be available. It's a loss. Simple. Expenditure account. Follow me, yes, sir. So I hope those reasons are very clear. So if you are changing any method or approach, kindly refer this. Kindly refer this. So whenever you are changing it, just mention about this change. It is given in AS-1, AS-6, AS-5. Some are given here. That's the problem. Change of depreciation is always change in accounting policy. Now, there was one more point. Again, I'm not even reading presentation, I'm just covering those discussion of AS6, AS10, which was asked during the break. There was one query, sir, let's suppose we have purchased a computer for 100 rupees and we were thinking that its life is 5 years, right? We were thinking its life is 5 years. They are using an SLA method. After 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. Depreciation 20, 20, 20. Book value 80, 60, 40. The query was, sir, now, if in this computer, I get new RAM, new hard disk, new screen at an expenditure of, let's say, 120. It's a very common example. No one says to dispose of all the assets. If you can improve it, then why not? At a lesser cost. Generally, computer labs mein hota hai. Now, if you do it, the life, new life, new estimated life will be, let's say, 10 years. new estimated life will be 10 years. What will be the depreciation for this? This was again a query during the break. Okay, first is 1.6. Second option, 32? 32, okay.
That is the value addition in the depreciated asset. That's the value has become to 160, right, and 20% depreciation on that asset, that comes to 32.
What is the depreciation?
Depreciation on 120 plus 640, 160. So once on 160, the depreciation at the rate of 20%, that is given
no.
32.
Rate will not be 20%, sir. 20. How much, sir? 16. How many of them 16? Sir, now the life has changed. You cannot charge this rate. Now because life is what, 10 years? Now if you see, have I changed the method or have I changed the historical cost or the life? So whenever method is not changed, whenever only cost is changed, life is changed, scrap is changed, it is always known as change in accounting estimate. Estimate is always from the date when it is changed.
But see, suppose when we edit RAM and hard disk and spin, let's see, after 3-4 years, then these item might have purchase of less than 5,000 rupees, for example. We will say these are the consumable item. We will not account for the main book value.
Hey, sir. You can,
normally it is happening.
Sir, that you can treat them as consumable when they are not purchased not for specific asset. They are being purchased for a specific asset and therefore should be added to the cost of the asset. If you are charging it as an expenditure, you are doing wrong, because these have increased the life of the asset.
So that
had there be? No, it's a normal expenditure.
Then it's a normal expenditure.
Good point. His point is, if RAM, earlier RAM was not doing proper work and you just replace the same RAM,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Then you have not increased the efficiency, you maintain the efficiency.
But now when we replace, we may opt for the higher RAM. Then,
sir, if you are opting for the higher RAM, yes, higher hard disk, yes, and guaranteed your efficiency can increase, right? So logically, your life will be improved. Even market value can increase. Tell me a computer having a 1 GB RAM and you replace it with 3 GB RAM.
Definitely.
When the value had increased, it becomes a capital expenditure, sir. Aapka wo 0.5 chalega tab theek hota if you are just only replacing to maintain the same level. But when you are increasing it, it's always a capital expenditure, sir.
Expenditure on the add-on, should it be booked on the book value or the then depreciated value?
The value which is appearing in your balance sheet at a time. Value which is appearing is, sir, 40. Sir, please.
Efficiency is not increased, but the life is increased due to replacement of that part then.
So it's a very, very simple concept of revenue capital. If any expenditure which only maintains the same, maintains bhi jab aapne wo kharida tha, to guarantee aapko ek life, ek value ki guarantee kari gayi thi. Ki this will run for 5 years. This will run for these many hours. Right? This will run or this will give you that much average. I'll take 4 or 5 examples here. One example, in front of you have a laptop, the RAM and GB example. If I have purchased a petrol car, I was given a guarantee that it will give an average of 12. I have replaced with CNG, efficiency increases?
Yes.
Right. Next example, I was having an AC, right? Whenever I purchase an AC, someone advised me, please replace the compressor. Efficiency will not increase, but its life will increase.
Yes, sir.
Capital expenditure, right? Someone advised me, what do you do one thing in your house, right? You have only ground floor. Please create one floor more. I guarantee the moment I create one floor, it creates more space for me. Capital expenditure. So always, whenever you remove an important part and an important part only maintain the same level which was earlier, never a revenue. It has to improve something over and above the original asset. जब नया asset हमने खरीदा था तो नए asset के time से कुछ ज़्यादा मिलेगा आपको, तब आप उसे बोलते हैं capital expenditure, otherwise नहीं, कभी नहीं आएगा.
It means capacity should also be increased.
Suppose one decided, the owner decided to put the reversible valve in that, so it becomes hot and cold. So its life will decrease, or efficiency will increase because you, one will enjoy, the owner will enjoy in hot weather and the cold weather, but life will decrease.
Sir, life of CNG may be decreased, but CNG of your average increases. When you put a CNG gas cylinder in your cars, the life of the car gets reduced, but because it increases the efficiency, it's a major expenditure, you always charge a capital expenditure. Or you will be surprised, nowhere it is the guidelines are given. Even only AS-10 says, AS-10 says, if the efficiency get increased, capital. Sir, aap kuch keh rahe hain?
Sir, in case, it means efficiency as well as useful life, both should be increased, then only
not both.
Will you capitalize?
Anything which is an improvement over the original, anything which has an improvement over the other, original one, it's a capital. And I always advise one thing, never go by the amount. I was surprised to see one annual report was written, because the amount is very, very huge, we are charging as a capital expenditure. No. Yesterday I took example, your auditor might be charging 3 lakh rupees and your furniture is hardly 100 rupees. Furniture will still be shown in the balance sheet, but not the audit fees.
It means the capacity is same, but the life is increased, then we can capitalize?
Bilkul, sir. Life, efficiency, average, capacity, at least some improvement should be there, which was not earlier guaranteed. Original nahi tha wo. Ya sir ne kaha hot and cold wala. Agar hot and cold ke andar, earlier nahi hai, and due to this, he is feeling that at least we are getting some more benefit, capitalized.
Asset is 20 lakh rupees. Yeah. And suppose 2 years ago, student theft in the library and they kept the book. Suppose we physically we verify and it found that the stolen book price was originally 5 lakh rupees. Then what is the treatment for this?
Let's take this example. Sir, in the library, books worth
20 lakh rupees is on debt.
Okay, sir. Right?
Yeah.
Chori hui hai? Yeah. When?
5 lakh rupees. Before 3 years.
Pehle ho gaya.
Before 3 years, 5 lakh rupees ki book chori hui hai.
But ye, it means in this value already that 5 lakh is included?
Huh? Originally, jo humne kitab khareedi thi, uska depreciation charge karte karte aur nayi book bhi aati gayi aur. आज की तारीख में असेट वैल्यू बुक की 20 लाख रुपए बता रहा है जो स्टोलन बुक हुई है सपोज फिजिकली वेरीफाई होते कि कौन कौन सी बुक चोरी हुई सपोज उसकी ओरिजिनल वैल्यू हम कैलकुलेट करते तो 5 लाख रुपए ही तो इसका आज ट्रीटमेंट क्या करेंगे और हाँ सपोज वो बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर ये भी ले लेता कि इन बुक को अब राइट ऑफ माना जाए तो एंट्री क्या पास होगी
बहुत सिंपल है सर फर्स्ट थिंग ऑन 31st March 2014 Let's suppose somewhere here, some student has stolen it, right? And you are saying that you are not able to find out whether it was stolen or not. Physically, verification was done later. It means in the year, let's say, 11, you are saying its value is 5 lakh, agreed? Have you passed any entry in 11 for this?
No.
No entry.
Because as on date, we actually found because physical verification.
Done. Bilkul sir, done. It means physical verification was done here.
Yeah.
Agreed, sir?
Yeah.
It means, let's suppose it was for 30 lakh. You have charged a depreciation 3 here. And it's coming to be in your books 21 lakhs. Now his point is, now during the physical verification after 3 years, it was noticed that some books were stolen earlier. First of all, I am telling you, during physical verification, it will not be easy to find out when it was stolen. Because you are doing a physical verification in which year? 31st March 40. I'm going very slowly. First thing, it will be very tough to find out when it was stolen. I agree, let's suppose.
Suppose we know the exact date.
Agreed?
This day lock was broken and student kept the book.
Sir, I agree, I'm taking it. Agreed, done. Student has done on 31st March 11. Done. It means you have charged on 5 lakh. Logically, you should have charged on 15 lakh. Right? Because 25 lakh. 30 lakh, 10%, 3, 3, and 3. Right? You were not able to identify after 3 years you came to know, sorry, on 5 lakh we have charged extra amount. It means on 25, 10%. Right, sir? So logically, agar hame chori ka pata chal jata, if we were able to identify, we should have charged on 25. It means you have overstated by 1.5. It's a prior period item. The error which you have find out now. AS-5 says, Anand is here, he will be taking it. So, any item of income or expense which arise in the current period due to the error or the omission relates to the earlier year is charged as a prior period. So, current year mein sir, aapke income expenditure account mein, aap aise dikhayenge. That 1.5 extra charge ho gaya, reverse. Iski ab entry. So logically books ki value increase honi chahiye. So entry will be, if you want to go by the 1-1 prior period, and then this prior period will be closed. Income and expenditure. So balance sheet mein aapki books aayengi 22.5 and it will be charged as 1.5. Aap bataiye sir, koi aur kar rahi hai. Most welcome. Whether satisfied or not?
It's only 1.5 lakh. What about the 5 lakh rupees? That too has to be charged.
Sir, wo to is saal mein charge hoga na. Agar loss ho gaya hai, to he has given me the value. Logically, this 5 lakh rupees hoga, wo loss mein charge hoga physical verification. Whether it is recoverable or not, loss charge hoga to. I am only taking the entry for the depreciation difference. The entire 5 lakh during physical verification, if it's a loss, its entire part will be charged immediately to expenditure and subtract from the asset account.
Sir, okay, let us change the query little
bit.
Bolo,
please.
Sir, if an asset is stolen before it is fully depreciated.
Please, bolo. Let's take an example, na. Bolo.
Yes, this is an example, sir. If an asset is stolen before it is fully depreciated.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's take any figure. Become easier.
Let it be 1,000.
Okay, 1,000 asset.
Okay, now an inquiry is initiated against this loss. So, in the meantime, accounts are to be closed on 31st.
31st March. Done?
Yeah.
And this fixed asset has been stolen? This fixed asset has been stolen?
Yeah, okay, it's stolen. Now, inquiry is initiated. Accounts are to be closed. A decision has not been come whether it is to be treated as a loss or not, because inquiry is not completed yet. Should we show it in our balance sheet or not? Should we wait for the...
Very simple. Sir, please.
The first of the asset was 5 lakh 3 years back. And during this year of 3 years, I have provided depreciation at the rate of 50,000 per year.
So my accumulated depreciation on stolen books is 1.5 lakhs. So if we deduct 1.5 lakhs from 5 lakhs, written-down value is 3.5 lakhs, okay? So the entry should be provision for depreciation debit 1.5 lakhs, loss on sale of asset debit 3.5 lakhs, and two books, sir, will be out. So from the gross block, I am just writing off the asset, and the loss will go to the income expenditure, and provision for depreciation will be reduced by that extent.
I have only given the net effect. Otherwise, yes, when accumulated depreciation is prepared, you transfer it from the ED account, and the balance is charged as a loss.
When we always used to show the balance is gross block, less provision for depreciation, and net block.
Sir, if you see, even here, right, the treatment which you are mentioning, right, actual loss is 5 lakh. I have not passed, the loss entry.
Actual loss is 3.5 lakhs.
I agree. 5 lakh is a book loss. If you see, I have reversed 1.5 there.
Yeah. Gross block will be reduced by 5 lakhs.
Right. What is the net effect comes? I have not given the full entry. Sir ka query sirf mainly tha uske liye. Otherwise, yes, if I go by the procedure, it becomes a long procedure, AD account, debit, everything. What discarded mein, demolish mein, scrap mein aata hai. Now here, sir ka ek query tha, bataiye iska reply, then I'll give the reply. Sir ka reply ye tha, ek question hai. Ek question, if 1000 is the asset which was stolen in the month of February, on 31st March balance sheet is to be finalized, right sir? And inquiry has been initiated. Now his query is whether we should show that asset in our books or not. Any query, sir? Right. Sir, isme na, again, ye Anand ka point hai, toh I will just only brief it here. It is again AS-29. AS-29 was the first time in the history of ICI they have defined what is provision, what is liability, what is contingent liability, what is contingent asset. Now this asset logically has been stolen. As it has been stolen before 31st March, you already must have passed the entry of stolen, guaranteed. Entire depreciation must have been debited. So your entry, let's suppose book value was 100, depreciation was 20, immediately you will charge the loss. Assuming it is a provision, and you will show in the footnote, as per AS-29, the inquiry has been initiated. In future, let's suppose you get the asset back, very good. You reverse the entry, that's a provision, that's a change in estimate. And change in estimate is allowed, always allowed, right? Please.
Sir, MHRD has issued a circular that if an officer who has been allotted a laptop, in case he resigns or he retires, he can take that laptop to his home according to 15% SLM depreciation method. But we normally use 60% WDV. In case after allotment of laptop, after 1 year he left the institute and he opted to take the laptop with him, then how that profit is to be booked?
Sir, ye point na income tax mein bhi hai. Income tax mein bhi point hai. In case of employee, right? In case of employee leaves and the employer gives the asset, then logically usme rates given hai. Ki then calculate the book value. So let's suppose, again this query which sir has raised it, anyone has faced in practical life?
Okay.
So kaise karte hain isko aap? Example is, sir, let's suppose 100 rupees ka computer. In your books, 60% you have charged. So in your balance sheet, you are showing 40 rupees. Now let's suppose I am the employee and I have taken this laptop at my home. And as per the Ministry of HRD guidelines, 15% 85. It means basically 45 rupees extra I'll be paying you guys. Yehi matlab hai sir? Right. Bataiye sir. then I'll share my point. आप कैसे करते हैं सर?
हमारे तो नॉमिनल वैल्यू फिक्स कर दी ईयर बाय ईयर, इतने साल में जाएंगे उसको 5000 रुपये देना है, 3000 रुपये, 2000 रुपये।
बट ही सेइंग कि मिनी से बेचारी गाइडलाइन से कैसे कुछ है सर? अरे मुझे नहीं आइडिया सर। वो डेप्रिसिएशन लिखा होगा 15%। सर देखिए, इफ यू वांट टू टेक इट वेरी सिंपल लॉजिकली, योर लैपटॉप विल गो 40, द मोमेंट इट गोज योर एक्युमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन विल बी डेबिटेड। नाउ आई एम टेकिंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप सर, ठीक है? सो एक्युमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन विल बी 60. यू ऑलवेज रिकॉर्ड दिस एट द कॉस्ट, because then your laptop will be 100 and your depreciation will be at 60, like a gross block. Gross block 100 ka aayega, AD 60 ka dikhega. Now you will recover cash, what, 45 rupees balance. When you recover the cash, logically how much extra you have recovered? 5. That has to be treated as your income. Sir, please.
Book value is shown in the books of account, which is 40 rupees only.
So, agreed. You never show the net amount. You always show prepare a fix as a schedule. Gross block 100 and depreciation 60.
No, point is different, sir. Suppose the employee doesn't return the laptop, how much amount is to be recovered? I think he was asking that point only. The amount to...
अगर रिटर्न नहीं करेगा तो लॉजिकली दैट लैपटॉप इन गवर्नमेंट बॉडीज इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल कि वो रिटर्न नहीं करेगा, समथिंग हैज़ टू बी रिकवर्ड, उसकी सैलरी कट जाएगी।
ठीक है, दैट इज द पॉइंट ही इज आस्किंग, हाउ मच रिकवरी इज टू बी मेड फ्रॉम हिम, हाउ मच रिकवरी इज टू बी मेड, वेदर द 40 रुपीस टू बी रिकवर्ड और द गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी।
सॉरी, आई टू गेट इफ वो सैलरी हैज़ टू बी डिडक्टेड, लॉजिकली सी दैट डिसीजन मैनेजमेंट हैज़ टू टेक इट। But if you ask me, what is the depreciated value at present? 40 rupees. So logically, you should only cut 40 rupees.
No, but it is not permitted like that, sir. Because the option to take the laptop is only after 5 years. So but and the accounting...
Income point is 15%. 15% ek saal ke baad chala gaya ho.
So 15% is the rate of depreciation which is prescribed.
सर इनका पॉइंट ये था कि 1 ईयर के बाद ही वो ले गया।
एग्जैक्टली सर, आई एम कमिंग टू दैट पॉइंट दैट 15% रेट इज टू बी चार्ज ऑन लैपटॉप एंड आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स द एम्प्लॉई हैज द ऑप्शन आइदर टू रिटर्न द लैपटॉप और रिटेन इट एट द बुक वैल्यू।
ठीक है,
नाउ आफ्टर 1 ईयर द एम्प्लॉई रिटेन्स और एम्प्लॉई डजंट रिटर्न टू द ऑफिस एंड व्हाट इज द अमाउंट, वेदर द अमाउंट विच इज अपेयरिंग इन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट इज टू बी रिकवर्ड और 15% अमाउंट ओनली इज टू बी यू नो डिडक्टेड।
सर बॉस,
85 will be recovered, not the book value. Yeah, 85, because this is the accounting treatment only which is given 100, in the books of account.
100, 15, 15, 15, 15, 15, right sir?
Yeah.
Now here, 60. This is as per the depreciation, this is as per the Ministry of HRD guidelines. You are saying after 5 years, let's suppose employee after this.
Remaining is scrap value, the government considers the scrap value.
Doesn't return. So logically, 85 will be recovered.
85 will be recovered, 100%.
Because we are not, if recovery has to be done, we are not concerned with accounting part. We are concerned with the MHRD guidelines.
Same thing in the books. Because employees waits, you charge 40%, I will take it.
Otherwise, some item of heritage value can be taken by the employee and the book value.
I agree.
Book value only can.
Sir, so इसमें तो point बहुत clear है. Forget about the accounting practices. इसमें तो जो गाइडलाइंस है वो फॉलो मानना पड़ेगा। गेट यू राइट। और बोलिए, लॉट ऑफ क्वेरी बिकॉज। यस मैडम,
डिप्रिशिएटेड वैल्यू कैन नॉट बी अ बेस टू, आई डोंट थिंक सो इट कैन बी अ बेस फॉर कंसीडरिंग दिस इशू वेदर ही शुड रिटर्न। आई थिंक दिस इज ओनली फॉर अकाउंटिंग पर्पस, नॉट फॉर कस्टडियन ऑफ द आइटम। और I think he, if there's a provision, a guideline that he can keep, or return if he keeps it, he has to pay the procurement price?
No, madam. It's not possible.
Or should he pay the depreciated value of that
procurement
asset?
Price, if he has to pay, he will never take it. He will go for the market price. If he has to pay the procured price, 100 rupees, why he will purchase a second machine?
Or the current market price, whichever is less.
Yes.
But not depreciated value. That's only, so I just want to...
See, that's what I'm saying now. As per the rules, it's 15 rupees, 15% return in the guidelines. Mm. They are saying. So as per that, the lower value is 85. The market price must be 100. The lower has to be 85. Because how you find the lower value? You always find the market price first of all. Mm-hmm. Let's suppose AC I am purchasing from you. I will first see what is the market price of the new AC. I'll see what is the price which is available in your books or maybe the depreciated rate. Compare it. The lower I'll pay to you.
Lower, he will pay the lowest.
Higher, ma'am, why I'll pay higher? If I have to pay higher, I'll go to the market. I'll come to you. What? I'm just sharing with you what local government is doing it. Local governments, when the reforms were introduced, it was clear instruction of the central government that if you do not prepare the accounts on double entry basis, your grants will not be released. So every year they used to take out the tenders for CA firms. CA firms used to come in the month of February, March, take the trial from you, convert into accrual entries, and help you for 2 or 3 years. And on the job training.
Sir, one thing, I think you should sit together as the CSG and India.
I don't mind. Sir,
Chartered Accountant of India, because there are two opinions. They are saying something, you are saying something. They are not actually, this are not similar.
Sir, what I am saying, as per the AS. What they are saying, primarily two or three people, they are saying as per the practices which they have been following till now. The practices which they have been following is not as per the accounting standards. So logical deviation has to be there. Deviation has to be there.
Now, there should be an understanding between you and CSG.
Sir, oh, sorry.
And now, what? Difference?
I can
difference say, should not be.
Sir, that CNAG task is a government body. That task has to be done by the Ministry of HRD. So, slowly and gradually, of course, it's a.
Now, they are also following this AS.
Sir, wo nahi follow karte hai na. Ab, if they would have followed AS, tell me honestly, how many of you have actually said to
they
them?
They are also guided by these rules, yes.
Sir, they are mainly guided by their own government financial rules. वो government financial follow करते हैं, वो GFR करते हैं. आप कभी उनसे आप कभी उनसे चलिए.
We are telling them, we prepared as per guidelines of AS.
We'll have a break for tea, then Anand will resume it session. Thank you.